Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Mystics MMOs. I am your host, Mystic Raven, and oh my god, do I have a treat for you guys today. Look at this. Here we are, boys and girls. It's here. I know. It's crazy. I'm hoping this turns out okay. I have to use my phone because there's no Windows mode that's currently working with this as we speak. So I'm a little whatever about it. I'm making sure it's working. I'm checking the phone out right now to make sure everything's on the screen as it should be. So this is crazy though. Yep, it's working. Perfect. I'm going to keep this up so I can conversate. Also, what I'm going to do, I keep forgetting I don't use that. All right, so another thing I got to do, I got to turn down some of the sound. I'm hoping I can. So let's go down to sounds. I'm going to turn down the master volume a little bit. All right, so yeah, here it is, man. I mean, a game long forgotten, no longer ran by Sony Online Entertainment. This is Star Wars Galaxies EMU. So I'm on the EMU server. And as you guys can see, you know, it's a little dated graphically. But wow. I just started this character yesterday. I had the disc. I was a hardcore Star Wars fan. There's no WASD, it's just point click. Okay, so I gotta build up stuff, so excuse me as I'm trying to get in my it's turn-based, and I'm just basically working my TK. And I'll explain this game in its entirety. Might even get my ass kicked here. My buffs wore off. That's another thing. I gotta go get buffs. Oh shit. Gonna get my ass kicked by a womp rat. Yep, incapacitated. That womp rat just kicked my ass. Go figure. Because I don't have buffs. I'll go get buffs. But this is an old game. It's turn-based. It's very old. Very, very, very old. This is a very old game. The last thing I want to do is actually get into whatever. So let me open up my map, set my waypoint, and I'll go back to Mos Eisley. Surprisingly enough, this game is doing pretty good over here. Now, I'm usually on whatever. Okay, I'm going to throw up the open terrain map, and then I'm going to open up the world map, if I can remember the world map icon. It's been a minute. That's inventory. There it is. So I have to go to Mos Eisley. Okay. Meters away. No, that's Mos Espa. I need Mos Eisley. Let me just do it the easiest way. Cities, Mos Eisley. Great waypoint. There we go. That's a little bit closer, I'd say. Okay, I'm going to close that out. I'm going to call it my speeder. 15 seconds. This is an old game, man. Like I said, I haven't even been on this game forever. My friend was like, dude, you got to download this. And I'm like, I haven't played it forever. Now, I want to get into all the conversation based around SWG, right? What happened to SWG? Well, you know, prior to KOTOR, this was the game. Now, as you guys can see right here, this is a player city. I'm not it, like all these little green buildings on my screen on my overlay map are player houses. player buildings that are created and crafted. And one of the major features about this game was it was sandbox, right? So players controlled the game environment, like the crafting, trade aspect, harvesting. Every aspect to this game was player-driven. And as you guys can see, this is a huge player city. This isn't small. This is friggin' massive. Now, my speeder's slow. I do apologize. This is like a. I don't even have TK unlocked to one yet. And it's dated. The graphically, it's dated. But at one time, this game was the shit. And it didn't have PvE content. Phil, what in the goddamn? Yeah, dude, I'm playing. Well, my server's down for DC. So I wanted to get into an old game, a very old game, that hasn't been seen in some time. And that is this game right here, SWG. So, what's up, Warren? Hope you're doing good today. So the one thing about this game, like I said, not only was it player-driven, which was amazing, like look over there, somebody's in combat, and you can see the combat from here. Now I'm on Tatooine, so that's the thing. There's like Womp Rats. I like certain things are non-hostile, and I shouldn't aggro whatever. And I do apologize. I'm in a crater with the speeder. But I'm heading over to Mos Eisley to get my buffs. There's a player. These Womp Rats smacking. Now, this is an NPC city that is in the movies, and we know it as Mos Eisley. So as I'm approaching Mos Eisley, this is a player city. I will be heading to the cantina, and I will be getting buffs from players. Now, majority of the time, players are AFK. Now, to play this game currently, to play the Emu, it's free, but you had to own the copy of the game. Now, if you own the copy of the game, you could play it, because that was one of the things, like SOE couldn't like shut down players who owned the game, like because if you owned it, that was your legal right. You know, you were paying for Star Wars SOE services, not for the purchase of the product. So once you purchase the product, so long as they redid like some of the source codes, it was all good. Now hold on, I'm going to be getting off my little, and then I'll store it. Okay. And the map is a little whatever, but it just helps me navigate the city, the overlay map. And then I'll turn it off. And I'll show you guys what's going on here. It's been a minute. It's been a long time. Okay. So I'm going to just hit Control M. That'll throw that off. My overlay map. I mean, this game is just so crazy. I'm like, what the hell? Now, there's a player. Any blue names are players. So there's a player. And as I'm walking in the cantina, these are all players. These are all players in this cantina. That's almost like, what? And this game came out in, I want to say, my daughter was 3. So 2003 is when this game came out. So this game is like, what? Like, that's like over 10, like over a decade ago, then this game came out. And like I said, prior to whatever, this is how it is. Now, like Master Dancer here, I want to do invite to like here, Mirka. So I'm going to backslash tell Mirka invite. Oh. And she'll have a macro that will invite me. Says not online. Mikra. MEK. Okay. Auto response. And then basically I'll get my buffs, which I need. So should be coming up through her rotation or whatever. Sometimes there are or I can probably tell you dumb. I cannot believe somebody named their character that. Some people have their macros up. Or Glaze, let's see Glaze if they'll do it. Just basically are trying to get like an auto, someone who has they're up Norcus. Okay. I think I've got most of the musicians here. There it is. There it is. Okay, so I'm gonna click this. Okay, so I'm in my group. Now all I have to do is just click on this and listen. Right? And now I'm getting buffs. You'll see on the right here, like, I'll have a buff screen up. That's what be applied buffs. So why this doing this? Let me see what's up. Nice, Zabrak. Yeah! Why are we not funding this? Well, you can. All you have to, but you have to have a copy of the game. If you have a copy of the game, listen, if you have a copy of the game, you can download it, go to Star Wars Emu, and literally play it and donate money to the developers. 15 years, yeah. Imagine this in Elder Scrolls, how it would have been perfect. Would work pre first. Have people found the School of Magic, Raise Towns Wars. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. So, like I said, it's crazy. Like how much this game is. Now, while this is going, I can kind of explain to players who's never seen this, what was the big hype around Star Wars Galaxies? Well, let me introduce you to the skill tree, right? So right here I have 250 skill points, right? To distribute as I see fit. As I see fit towards my build, right? Towards my character development. Now, I already got one bar into two-handed, but I need to like raise my unarmed street fighting, which is Terracotta. Because when I look at all the professions, there are prerequisites to unlock said profession, and that was the big deal. So these are what we call the first ones are called base skills, and then we got into the big ones, like the huge ones. Now, like I said, the graphic quality is pretty whatever, but look, shipwright. I can craft a shipwright. I can fly in space, like open space in this game. It is crazy how well you are a crafter in this game. You are a true crafter. Players buy player crafted material. They don't depend on looted material, looted stuff. They depend on player material, player stuff. It's crazy. You can do doctor, creature handler was huge, commando. I'm going for my TK, which is my Terracotta, because prior to being a Jedi, Terracotta with Fencer was the best. Because when you take a look at like this, you'll see like you'll get all these bonuses every time you go up in a tree. You'll get melee damage mitigation on our knockdown. I scroll up, I get all these different applied bonuses every time I progress in my tree line, right? That's how it's been calculated. melee damage mitigation 2, unarmed knockdown, unarmed toughness. We go in, we have a meditation tree, power boost. We got unarmed speed, that's how fast you hit, unarmed damage, how hard you hit. This was where character, like players could, you know, it was sandbox. It had the outline, you had to decide which way you were going to build your character. It was probably one of the biggest things I have ever seen when we take a look, you know, back in the day. Now, I'm not getting any buffs from this dude, so I'm actually going to stop listening to him. Ugh. I want buffs. He's not applying buffs. Okay. Norcus. I can watch Norcus. She'll apply buffs. There's my buffs. So I can watch her and listen to him. So I'm just getting buffs. As many buffs as possible. I was hoping Mirka was on here, but... Speed buff, both dance and music. Guess I'm going to listen and watch at the same time. Okay. So I'm just getting buffs. Players apply buffs. You're not dependent on it. You're dependent on players. And this is the cantina. Like, all of these are players. These are players in here getting buffs. Some are AFK. Some are just like, hey, you know what? I'm going to do this. Look, there's people in the chat room, whatever. It's pretty cool. I'll play a little RPG. Hello, Rebel Scum. Convert to the Empire. Oh my god, this is so crazy. Like, I'm usually in DCUO. But like I said, you know, unfortunately, you know, tips... They're taking tips. I'm a noob. I have nothing to tip them. Nothing. But that's kind of cool that they're here. You can get like really crazy amount of buffs here. This is probably one of the weakest buffs I've seen. Why isn't this guy buffing? Something's fucked with his shit. Why am I not getting these buffs? Probably because I'm listening to this person. Let me try that now. It's crazy. But I wanted to get on here. This game has so many different aspects of memories for me. So many. I already have my buffs from this person. So, I'm... There it is. There's a speed buff. Focus. Willpower. I have some damage. Mind. I think it's all from dancer. Okay, so I have those buffs. Okay, so I'm gonna leave group, and then I'm gonna see if I can find another buffer. Sometimes you can get other buffs applied depending on what they have. Oop. That's a novice entertainer, master. So, and then you just oh, too many E's. Now have a macro. It's just that simple. You have to be in their group to get their buffs, or else you're just listening. Because they're buffing group members. And sometimes they'll just have the macros up. There it is. Okay, now I'm gonna watch this person. You gotta pay attention to what kind of buffs you're getting, obviously. Let's see if these buffs are getting. Trying to get my buffs on. Don't judge me. I can't believe this. This is like, you know, way, way back a long time ago. This is what I started off, well, I didn't start off with. But like back in the day, I became a Jedi. Did the Holocron unlock. Did Jedi. Became a Master Jedi. Then I also got, I ended up becoming a Elder Jedi. And that was pretty intense back in the day. Like how, you know, good of a player. Prior to that, I was a crafter. Crafting in this game meant a lot to me, like what I contributed to the game community for crafting. You know, I was an artisan, so I crafted like tons of different stuff. Mainly housing is what I started off with. Then I did cooking in this game, very important, food buffs. And then for 2 minute buffs. For 3.5 hours. Crazy. And they just get XP for this. Got a 1 hour buff. I got a 1 hour buff. So I'm going to listen for about 2 minutes. And then see if I get any other buffs. If not, then poof. I'm out. Try to kill some womp rats. People are commercializing. There's a 3PO protocol droid. Oh my god. Crazy. Just when you think. All right. All right. Okay, I'm gonna leave group. Crazy, man, I'm telling you. But yeah, looky. These are players. Everything in blue is players. There's a quest provider over there. They got a little band going on. How amazing. This is, man, this is taking me back. This is all taking me back so much. There's a lot of nostalgia right here. A lot of nostalgia. Once again, it is a little dated. Not saying it's not. But back in the day, this was like why a lot of players really enjoyed this game. Okay, so I gotta, whatever. Oh my god. I can't drive very well. You guys have seen me drive. If anybody's seen me drive, they know I'm a terrible driver. They have star shuttle shuttles. I can go to other planets, explore. That was the biggest thing, and that's one of the things that I really felt upset with when I tried KOTOR. I thought KOTOR was very well done, don't get me wrong, but there was a lot of points to KOTOR. I felt like it missed the mark. Like, exploration, it was one of the biggest things. You have a vast universe, huge game, and literally you're confining your players to like little areas which they'll play at a level and they'll never go back to. I mean, unless they build an ult. And it was like, that sort of sucks. That was like the most suckiest aspect. Rubber banding is very real in this game. I used to remember rubber banding all the time. The game definitely had its glitches. I feel like the guys who were behind this are doing really good work, given the fact how old the game is. And it's kind of refreshing to see that players enjoyed the game so much that they wanted to keep it going. Now, for me personally, I probably won't like return to this game full time, but I wanted a throwback, man. I was like, I want to do a throwback version of Star Wars Galaxies, man. And EMU is going to give me that, you know, opportunity to do that. And once again, like, this is a player city I'm coming up on. It's not on the map, it's not on the registry. So this is a player ran city, and they can get all these really cool things. They can get starports, everything else going on in their city. And it's pretty cool, man. You know that there's, you know, you can, these are harvesters. It's literally, this is how the game used to run, was off the player community. And to see a city this big, a player city this big, it's amazing. It's simply amazing to think how many players who own the game are still playing Star Wars Galaxies. It's simply amazing. Now, in Endgame, there's no content. It's all about the Galactic Civil War. It's about the GCW. The GCW is your Endgame everything. Like, I'm Imperial. I'm not I'm not a Rebel. I'm an Imperial player. So, you know, I side with the dark side of whatever. I enjoyed playing Imperial for the longest time. I used to have like the Stormtrooper gear. I had the AT-STs, you know. I had the walker. It's crazy. All right, so I'm gonna exit the vehicle. I'm gonna store it. Probably get my ass kicked. Stand up. Probably still get my ass kicked. Over here, you'll see like all my commands being entered. And it's just turn-based, so the combat isn't very, very flashy. I can scroll in. All right. So I got two down. I'm going to try to find any more. There he is. As soon as you hit a base, man, the dude will just, they'll come out of the woodworks. Oh. Okay. Just an old game, man. Just wow. So, you know, you wouldn't think. Okay, I'm just gonna hit it once. Because usually more will come out. You can take missions at mission terminals. Who's gonna beat this thing with their bare hands, though? I mean, a lot of auto attacking. My gosh, this is like taking me way back. When turn-based was a thing. Like when this first came out, you were like, oh my god, okay, this is so cool. And now you take a look at it and you're like, man, it's so dated. But this was the shit. No game. Problem with new games is they avoid true sandbox games, man. So I've just completed my one mission. I get credit. I don't have to go turn in or whatever, which is kind of cool. So I've got my XP. So now I'm going to go ahead, call out my speeder. I'll go to my next mission area, which was the Womp Rats. And they'll give you missions based on your experience with your skills, which is kind of nice. You can get faster speeders, obviously, which is really cool. So, luckily, you know, both of my mission points were kind of close proximity surrounding this player's city. It's amazing. How many players are playing this game still? Holy shpliff. Is that the base? Oh my god, I think that is. Hold on, I think I'm about to show you guys a base. Hold on. I think there's a fucking base. It might be Imperial. It is. Oh my God, this is an Imperial city. Okay. This is an Imperial base. This is what the game was based around. Okay, so let me introduce you guys to the GCW. I think this is whatever. Let me store this because they can blow up my speeder. If it's not friendly. Yeah, oh, that's Rebel. Okay, so you'll see the Rebel icon. This is a Rebel base. And it has a turret, right? I'm not attacking it. They have turrets around it, right? And in this, and you'll see the Rebel flags. And for Imperial, they're Imperial flags. This was where PvP was, right? So what would they had this thing called V time, vulnerability time. And vulnerability time was very, very important for people trying to blow base. Now, as you guys can see, I don't have access to this. So you need somebody to hack it, right? So hacking these doors would basically, as you can see inside, there's all these little icons, right? Are all these little icons. Those are NPCs that are going to protect the hell out of this base. So what you end up doing is you want this base gone, right? Every base you were trying to blow up in the game, you would wait for what they call V time, and you would take a smuggler. And a smuggler was able to, see, there's a minefield. See, they're even putting out minefields. So as soon as you would engage combat, these things would blow, right? They would just go off. Boom, boom, boom. Turrets would start firing at your asses. And players would get alerts, and they would start coming and defending these bases. Because if it's their base, all of a sudden they get alert. Hey, this base is being attacked. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. And that's what you were trying to do in the end game. End game, there wasn't like any like raids or dungeons or all these crazy stuff going on. You were gearing up for Galactic Civil War. And this was one of the things you were always trying to look for was what? Bases to blow. You were always looking around for bases to blow. That was your whole end game, was PvP. You were basically looking to destroy everything that, you know, represented any sort of shit for your... Okay. I mean, it just takes you back. I mean, that was the most alluring part of the game, was the PvP. This was all based around PvP. All of it. All of it was PvP. Yeah, you had players create... Like, players. Some players wouldn't even be involved in Galactic Civil War. They would be doctors, crafters, artisans, different things going on like that. You know, a lot of... now, always, like, you would always store your vehicle, obviously, for whatever. There's a little fucking womp rat. I'm getting my ass kicked. Got two womp rats on me that's kicking my ass. And capped by a womp rat. Those buffs suck! I'll try it again. That one womp rat, I should have sat down. My fault. Now I have a longer in cap. So, anyways. Now, during your in cap, if you're PvPing, you'd be okay in PvE. Like doing missions and stuff. Like, I can backslash sit in front of this womp rat. And it ain't going to do shit. Right? Until I attack it. Now, during my sitting phase, I'll regenerate my health, my action, and my mind. So it's called HAM. H for health, A for action, M for mind. If any of those drop, at a zero level, you get incapped. So riflemen were really nasty because they would hit you from a long, what they call mine shots. And mine shots would literally deplete your mind. So if you got hit from a distance by a rifleman and he hit you with mine shots, snipe you with a mine shot or a headshot that affected your mind bar, you're fucked. You get incapped by like one or two shots. So you needed gear that would literally be specific towards preventing, you know, extra damage to your mind. And crafters would do that. Crafters would augment gear based on the HAM system, the HAM system. So it was really cool. Like back in the day, this was the game, man. This and Star Wars and SOE wanted to keep trying to get more players to play the game, since why they did the CU, which was the combat upgrade, which was fine. The combat upgrade had a couple of little hiccups, but it did what it was supposed to do, sped up the combat. And then you had the NGE, which was completely redid the entire fucking format of taking sandbox and converting it into a class-based game. And that's where things went completely wrong, because the Galactic Civil War was based on the whole premise of you needed this, and that to execute Galactic Civil War, and the new system glitched it up. It completely glitched up the GCW. It shouldn't have, but it did. And that's where players were all pissed, because they had no control over their development. And then the Galactic Civil War was fucking bugged up half the time due to the new class-based system. So it was like, oh shit, where literally you could almost build like a one-man hacker to hack the terminals in the bases. So you need one of every certain professions to hack terminals. And players could do like what we call a hacker build. So he has no function other than hacking terminals. He was a smuggler. He had this, and that, all for the purpose of hacking the terminals to blow to set the base to destruct. During this time, players like me would go ahead and help defend any oncoming players trying to defend the base. So we lead support to the what we call the hacker. But because he had all these professions to literally blow the base. So now while I'm regenning, so is the Swamp Rat. Sucks. So I'm actually going to see if I can single target another rat, because I'm just low level. I'm a lowbie. I'm a noob. I forgot how hard it is to level unarmed. Think I'm gonna get this little fucking rat. Oh my gosh. So one more and I'll have enough to level up. Sometimes I won't even worry about okay, I have to have X amount, you know, to get some of these missions done. Sometimes for me, literally, it was about trying to level up. That wasn't smart on my behalf. I should have sat that one out. I'll get incapped. This is where you want stem packs. Three incaps and you go back to the nearest cloning facility. On three. That's fine. Decayed items. So now I'm at a cloning facility. Mos Oesa. Oh, are you kidding me? That is so not close. Could also pick your lighting if it was dark out. These are player vendors training. And then I've just learned a new skill. And that's exactly how easy it is. Now when I open up my new skill line, you'll see that I have this when I go to Brawler. This is green now. And I have progression. I already started with two hand. Swordsman. Fencer, you need one hand. So literally to be a master brawler, you'd get a lot of perks, but literally one of the biggest things was one hand or fencer TK. So fencer all the way up, and then Terakasi expert master. Terakasi was where it was at for like tons of shit. You can do squad leader, swordsman, pikemen. Pikemen were really good. Pikemen were really good fencers. So this was it. Like, Master Fencer TK was badass combo. Badass. You take the buffs from the Terakasi and go with fencing, and you pretty much beat the shit out of everybody. These guys could hold their own with, like, this combo build held up with Jedi. Bounty Hunters were pretty beast, I'm not going to lie. Like, bounty hunters were really, really good. Really good. But I just wanted to kind of do a throwback in a lot of ways, what this game was, what it represented. Like, for example, if I go over here to the Star Terminal, I can literally go back to a station and travel a planet. Travel to another planet. Right? That was huge back in the day. This is what I think it is, isn't it? All right. Anyways, it's an old game, but it's good to see it thriving. It's good to see it. It's really good to see how this is a player. Looks like a player city. Just to think what players are doing with this type of game still is amazing. And I wish more MMOs. Updated MMOs would go here. Now, as you guys can see, I have a lot of wounds. I have to go to see a doctor about repairing my wounds. But seriously, this game takes me back, and the appeal to it. What was the appeal to Star Wars Galaxies besides being Star Wars? Besides the title, was very simple. Players could control how they made their character. Open world, right? These are player communities. These are player houses. These are player vendors. These are player, driven buffs. Everything is player driven. That was huge, right? Had the game had more indirect content, right? That could literally guide players to, development, and had they focused in on a few minor things, NG would never have had to come to fruition, and this game would have done better, a hell of a lot better. I played this game religiously for years until it shut down. From the time it opened to the time it got shut down, this was the game I played. From the time it launched to the time it shut down, this was my game. This was the game I played. And then when this game shut down, I finally went to World of Warcraft full time. Literally, it's amazing. The graphics are dated, but it had environmental changes. Like, you'd see the sun rise, you'd see the sunset, you'd see the night, you'd see the stars. You could go to all these different planets. You could, literally travel the entire planet, right, at your fingertips. And KOTOR failed in that aspect. KOTOR had a lot of superiority in many ways, but what it failed in was capturing the believer of a Star Wars player. To say, hey, I get to go to this planet. I get to see all of these things going on. Why, and I can go back and I can explore. One of the biggest things about Star Wars is exploration. Not only just walking in into a known part of what the lore of Star Wars, like, Tatooine and Naboo and so on and so forth. It's about exploring. What can I see that wasn't there? What hidden, things lurk in to the fans, the super fans. And that's where I felt like KOTOR just missed its point. Honestly, I felt like it was a good game. KOTOR is a good game, and the storylines are well done. The problem of it is it has nothing that appeals to the hardcore players. Like exploration, large giant battles. Like when I would go into space, I would do NPC missions, right? Which are like, docking, checking in with bases, couple incursions here and there, smuggles, space smuggle missions. That was cool. Like smuggling missions was really cool. But one of the biggest things was just running along. You're doing your thing, and I'm in a TIE fighter. And the next thing you know, here comes an X-Wing flying at me that's a PvP-er. Just randomly flying in the same friggin' corner of the galaxy. And I'm like, oh, hell no, it's on. And you get these space battles going on. And all of a sudden, you're flying. You're using a joystick. You're using a controller. And you guys are, like, literally on each other. It's like, dogfight. You're in a space dogfight for your life. And that was awesome. It was, and you get kills and you get points for your kills that goes towards, your faction. That this game had so much to offer when it came to the GCW, what it offered players as far as open content, but there was no direct content. There was nothing that was leading players. That was the only problem it had. And the Wookiee, they started getting into that, and I felt like it was moving in a positive direction. The problem of it is, by the time they actually started implementing more content for players, they decided to change the entire structure of the game, which was not a good idea for this game. Was not a good idea. Was not a sound idea. But when you walk into a community that's still being played, it's still being played by its fans, by the players who enjoyed what this game offered. That's a testament to the impact it had on the MMO community. This game, it might not have been as popular as World of Warcraft. It may not have been as popular as EverQuest and what Sony's expectations were. But the player base were committed. They were committed. You know, they didn't go anywhere. This game had probably the least amount of turnover rate than any other game would have ever had. And that's just a statement to any company moving forward. Don't piss off your loyal customers. Don't do it. It's not worth it. Because when you light a torch, nobody wants to see it extinguished. Nobody. Nobody wants to see that extinguished. So I'm going to go see if DCUO is finally up, but you know, like I said, I'm a noob, but it's amazing. It's actually pretty amazing to see that this game is still up and running. And it's doing well. You know, it's amazing. You know, it's not every day you get to see this type of game. That's a quest log. There it is. And those Isleys just around the corner. It's amazing, guys, I'm telling you. Not the flashiest combat system, but this game meant something to players. It really did. And seeing this player community and how what like there's a guild hall. You could probably actually even go in it. You're a special needs sold here. It's amazing. So old, but yet it's still good, man. I would applaud more companies to take the risks of like developing sandbox MMOs. Sandbox MMOs are very sought after by certain players. It is very much appreciated, and when you have players who enjoy your product, you will have them for a long haul, meaning years. Why? Now, there are certain things that you have to hit right in sandbox. PvP is the biggest one. That's the biggest attraction to sandbox MMOs is the PvP. All rules out the window. Open world PvP all day, every day. That's what sandbox MMOs bring. Is like, you know, the whole aspect of I can kill anybody anywhere if these conditions are met, you know. And there's that player, just still over here kicking ass. Or it's a new player. There he is sitting down. He's got the layer going on, the layer grind. Somebody's shit just got blown up. Oh my. I remember I got my Corvette done, and I got my speeder, my Corvette speeder. First day I'm out, I was flagged PvP. Didn't know it. And somebody blew up my speeder the first day I got my Corvette done. I was so pissed. I was so mad that my friggin' Corvette speeder just got blown to smithereens. And if anybody remembers like Corvette runs, that was like towards your end game. That was PvE end game. That was kind of crazy. Now over here you also see there's a giant spaceport, right? And that is where you go over here. That's what you go to leave the planets. Like I'm not stuck on this planet at all. If I want to go to Naboo, I can go to Naboo. If I want to go to Corellia, I can do that. I think they have Hoth. I want to say they have Hoth. Not sure. Not sure if they have Hoth, but we can find out. Hi, Rebel Scum. Okay, so I can go to the planet. So we have Corellia, Lok, Naboo, so they have four planets up. Theed, definitely all day, every day. Purchase ticket, tickets purchased. Exit it, and then we go out to the boarding area, which is a small Corvette. It doesn't even really look like the size of what a Corvette should have looked like. There's a master doctor. Dude, heal my wounds. Please and thank you. There's a protocol droid with the ship. Now, if you have your own ship, you can travel automatically. Double click and boom. I'm on my way to Naboo. This is where I was located for years. Everything was set up in Naboo, right outside of Theed. And as you can see, the buildings look different. The terrain is different. I mean, I can still remember where everything is in this part of the fucking map. I don't even need the mini map up on this. Oh my God, I still remember. Here is the vendors. Are the terminals? Speeder bike, somebody speeder bike. There's the Imperial guards. Imperial recruiters. That's where you buy your gear. Oh my God, shut up. That's how you flagged yourself. There's a creature handler running around with some stuff. Over here's the cantina. Oh my God, this is taking me back. That's auction terminals, bazaar terminals, or auction terminals. So crazy, man. Oh, dude, it's a walker. Somebody has their Imperial walker out. Oh my God. Oh my God. ATST, there's their AT. Oh, that's the ATST. Imperial walkers, you can get Imperial walkers too. Oh my God. Rancor, somebody has a Rancor. Get your fucking pets out of here. Put them somewhere. These are players. These are all fucking players. Oh my God. It's amazing. Bandage, yes. Yes. That's what I need. But anyways, guys, yeah, definitely. This just takes me back. So many things take me back to this game. Little dated, but it's not too bad. It's not too bad. I've seen worse. Just, it really does take you back to what this game really was. And there are players playing it. There's hundreds of players playing this game. Hundreds. They have multiple servers up. They're doing pretty good. It's amazing. If you have the Star Wars discs, you can download it and play this game. It's so long as it's pre-CU, I want to say. Like the collector's edition or the original one was the two discs that you could use. And if you don't have the game, if you can find them on eBay then or online, you can purchase the game and play it. These are bazaars. These are player crafted. This is the player market. So if they don't have a vendor and you were looking for gear, and I was like, oh, I'm a newbie. I don't know where anything is. This is where you went. Yeah. I don't need a tutorial there, bud. I know how to do this. So you can go through vendor location. You can bid. You can sales. You can look for armor. And then basically it's like this. Like here it is. 9,000 credits. Dude wants almost 20K credits for this arm. Now you can also look at it and it'll give you like the stats. All right. It's composite. Composite is just really good. So kinetic energy. And you could build the stats around everything. Acid, these are effectiveness. The vulnerabilities is down here. Your encumbrance is your health, your action, your mind, which is ham, once again, H-A-M. So, yeah, takes me back, man. Takes me back. Wow. This is where it was, man. Like, these are players. The NPCs aren't putting anything on these bazaars. These are players putting them on there. You can also look up vendor locations. And then you can see different things from the vendors who are listing. So it's kind of like advertisement. But anyways, guys, and we'll let you guys go. Once again, throwback. SWG, wow, amazing, simply amazing to see that the EMU community is doing so good. It looks healthy. I want to get once again want to thank the developers for taking this on, because you know, at one time this game meant the world to thousands of players, and I'm happy that they found refuge somewhere out there in the galaxy. All right, once again, I'm Mystic Raven. This is Mystics MMOs. Thank you guys for watching, and once again and always, have a nice day.